What a beautiful day to wake up to. If you watched last week's vlog, you will know that yesterday I tidied and decluttered and organised the craft room, and it is just so beautiful in here this morning with this gorgeous light that it's just calling me. So I'm going to come in here and do some crafting. I've got myself a little cup of tea ready. I'm going to light my wax burner. It's just beautiful in here now since we had those hedges cut. I just love it. I've got a stack of books up there, which I'll tell you more about in a minute, but I'm just loving it in here at the moment. Morning, everyone. Welcome to, is it week 10 of official isolation?
I'm not sure. I don't remember.
As I said, I wanted to speak to you about that stack of books I had. So this is my stack of books for the Readorama round 14, which is currently happening. It started yesterday and I think it runs until this coming Sunday. I need to double check that. But the main prompt is basically to read Around the Rainbow. So you are meant to read a book, or at least pop into your TBR a book that is either one of the colours of the rainbow or has a colour in the title. And I think there are a couple of other prompts as well, but I went with the rainbow prompt. And also, like, the challenge is to read 7 books. There's no way I'm going to read 7 books. I won't even read 6 books, especially because some of these are a little bit chunky. But I just picked out 6 books because I have a lack of purple books on my shelf, and indigo and violet were just too difficult to do because I didn't have any like purpley books that I hadn't read apart from this one, really. So I will show you my TBR pile for this week. It's a bit ambitious. Just because it's easier, I'm going to go in reverse order. So my violet book that I have is called Wicked Like a Wildfire. I can't even talk. Wicked Like a Wildfire by Lana Popovic. And I have no idea what this is about. I'm not even sure when I bought it. I think it's like a magical realism novel about two girls who are born with magical abilities that they have to hide. So I'm interested to get stuck into this, and it's one of those really nice floppy paperbacks. So that is my violet book. My blue book is Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson, and this is the first book in a trilogy that I have been wanting to read for a really long time. It's about a murder mystery at a boarding school, which is just right up my street, and I have a feeling I'm going to get sucked right into it. This is another really nice floppy paperback. My green book is The Toll by Neil Schusterman. This is the final book in the, I think it's called The Ark of the Scythe, I think, trilogy. I read the first two books when they first came out, loved them, thought they were amazing, so recently bought the third one and I can't wait to get stuck into it. But obviously it is a little bit chunky, so unless I have like a whole day of reading, it's highly unlikely I'm gonna get through this week, but we can try. And obviously I didn't want to give too much of a synopsis of that one because it gives away the first two books for people who haven't read them yet. But anyway, my yellow book is called Flawed, and it's by 7 authors, and you read from the perspective of 7 characters, and each author writes one of the characters' perspectives, I think. And it's hard to describe the synopsis of this one, so I'll just read it to you. It says, when they got in the lift, they were strangers. Sasha, who is desperately trying to deliver a parcel, Hugo, who knows he's the best looking guy in the lift and is eyeing up Velvet, who knows that what that look means. Dawson, who used to be on TV, used to be handsome and is sincerely hoping no one recognises him. Caitlin, who's losing her sight but won't admit it, and Joe, who shouldn't be here at all but wants to be here the most, and one more person who will bring them together again on the same day every year. Every day told 7 ways in this unique collaborative novel. I've had this on my shelf for such a long time and it really intrigued me at the time, and then I just have so many unread books that I kind of forgot about it, so a rainbow challenge was a really good time to pick this one up because obviously it's bright yellow, so hopefully I'll get to that this week. Next we have the book that I'm currently reading, and I've cheated and called this my orange book because I don't have any books that are orange that I haven't read. I've only got a handful on my shelves and I've read them all. So this one's my orange book because it's kind of orangey in the middle, and it's called All These Beautiful Strangers by Elizabeth Clayforth. I'm not sure Again, this is like a boarding school murder mystery, but it's about the mystery of the main character's mother's disappearance. I'm 186 pages in, and so far I'm finding it quite slow going, but it's also really intriguing. I want to finish it, I want to find out what happens, but it's just a bit of a slog at the moment. And again, it's a reasonably chunky one, so I hope that it picks up a little bit soon. And then my final book is my red book, and it's called The Girl in the Window by Penny Jolson. And it's about a girl who is quite ill and she has to stay inside, and she witnesses an abduction from her window. She's not sure what she saw at all. Again, it sounds really intriguing. It's a nice short one, so hopefully I will be able to read that this week. And it's another one that I've had on my shelf for a really long time. So yes, these are the six books that I would like to attempt to read this week. It's incredibly unlikely, but if I read a couple of them, I'll be really happy. So yeah. Morning everyone, happy Tuesday. I'm in the same top I was wearing last week. Although you guys probably won't remember that because it's been a week now since that vlog. Weekly vlog went up last night. Again, thank you for your lovely comments that have been left on it so far. It really does mean a lot to me. We've already had an eventful morning. We came downstairs to find an ant infestation in the kitchen, which was disgusting. Will has been like de-weeding the patio and de-weeding the driveway, and we think he must have disturbed a nest. And we've got like little cracks in the windowsill of our house because it's a like old house, just hasn't been taken care of particularly well. And we think that's where the ants were coming in. So that was pretty gross this morning. So we had to try and deal with that. And then Will nipped to B&Q to get some more stuff for the garden. He's not working today because his job's gone down to 4 days a week, and today is his day off this week. And so he went to B&Q to get some stuff for the garden, and he bought a garden like seating set that they had, and unfortunately they've sold him the wrong table and they don't have the correct one in stock, and they don't have the correct one in stock anywhere apart from like 30 miles away from us, so we think we're just going to order it online. But we need to take the other one back because they also he thought they'd overcharged him, and they haven't overcharged him, but we need to take it back anyway. So I think I'm gonna go along for the ride because I haven't left the house again in quite a long time. Haven't been on a walk again in a couple of days, so I'm gonna go and sit in the car for the ride. I finished my first book of the readathon this morning. I finished All These Beautiful Strangers by Elizabeth Clayforth. I'm not sure what her name is, but it was okay. It probably could have done with being like 100 pages shorter, to be honest. It was a very slow burn, and then all of a sudden at the end everything was just wrapped up like that. But I still gave it 4 stars because I did find it really intriguing. I did predict the ending, but that happens quite a lot. But yeah, thought it was good. So I finished my orangey book of the Rainbow Readathon, and I think I'm gonna take a book with me in the car when we go to another B&Q. Because we're going to go to another one because they didn't have some of the stuff that we wanted to get. So I think I'm going to take a book along with me for the ride and while I'm waiting in the car for Will's. You ready?
Yep.
Okie dokie, we're off.
I'm such an idiot. I'm in the car waiting for Will and I started reading this book, and then I realised I've already read it. So I'm going to have to pick another book to read when I get home.
I did to use bark instead of stones for this back bit of the garden because it would be cheaper and easier. So those are the stones that you saw in a previous vlog, and now we got some bark today and Will's just putting it down and it looks so much nicer. We've got the sleepers there, all the bark on the bottom, it looks so nice. I'm very impressed. Okay, my new look order just came, so I thought I would try it on. It's all different sizes because I basically bought what they had in stock. So my experience with New Look is that I'm not normally my... Archie's just tried to come upstairs. My experience with New Look is that I'm not normally like one size in there. It'll be like a different size in different styles. So I'm just going to try them on, see what they look like.
Okay. This is the first dress. It's really annoying because we don't have a full length mirror in our house, but this is the first one. You can't really see the colour properly. It's like a cornflower blue. It's really pretty. It obviously needs ironing. The collar is sitting up really high. And the bottom has a whacking great slit up the side. Didn't realise it was quite so high. I really want to love this, but I feel like maybe it's a little bit aging on me, but it's also like super comfy. I don't know, this is a maybe try it on a few times and think about it.
This is the bottom of the dress, so as I said, it needs ironing, but I think it's, I don't know, I think it's quite pretty. We have a tie waist, like culottes jumpsuit. Again, you just cannot see this on lean back. I can just picture this in the Disney parks with a pair of mini ears, looking adorable. Super comfy.
And this is the top. It's a little bit twisted. Big boob problems. But I'm not sure it's the most flattering on top, but I also don't have a very good bra on today. So perhaps if I was wearing a slightly more supportive bra, it would look a bit better, but it is really comfy. Okay, so this is the last dress and I don't really like it. My mum has it in green and she dropped off a plant pot on my doorstep the other day and I spoke to her on the driveway and she was wearing this dress in green and it was so nice. It just looked really beautiful on her. So I wanted the green one, but they didn't have it. So I thought I'd get the black one to try and I haven't done it up around the neck, so it's not really like sitting properly, but I just don't think it's, I don't know. I don't think it's a great style on me. I prefer the blue one. So I think I'm gonna send this one back, maybe swap it for something else or just get a refund on it and keep the other two, I think.
Now that I've sorted those out, here is my finished Animal Crossing journal. I'm not really a huge fan of the last few spreads in the journal. I'm hoping to film a flip through this week, so if you want to see a full flip, you can go and have a look. But yeah, I'm not a massive fan of the last few layouts that I did in this. I was sort of running out of patience with it, to be totally honest with you. But I basically documented from the first day I started playing until the day that I got 5 stars on my island. And it's cute and it's a nice little memento and it's another finished journal, so that is a win in my book. So now I think I might pick another book to read, because obviously I realized in the car earlier that I had already read the book that I started reading. In my defense, it was a couple of years ago, so I'd obviously just forgotten, but as soon as I started reading it, I was like, this feels so familiar, and I had a look on my Goodreads and I read it in 2018. So I need to pick another book for my Rainbow Readorama Challenge, or just start reading one of the other ones that I had set aside for it, and I might go out in the garden and read for a little while. I have a big long list of things I wanted to do this week. Haven't done any of them yet. Okay, I'm going to read this one. It has a red spine, so it counts. And it's called My Little Eye. Apparently it is a rocket-paced dark thriller. We'll give it a go.
Hi everyone. I really wanted to bring you some positivity this week, and I feel like my mood has been a lot better this week than previously, but I've woken up this morning and something is wrong with Winnie. Some of you might know that Dachshunds can be prone to back issues, and I think that that's what we're dealing with here. This morning when we woke up, she was just really sluggish and didn't want to do anything, wasn't running around like her normal self, and I thought that was a bit strange. And then she came to snuggle with me on the couch and she just settled straight down, whereas normally she jumps all over you trying to get up in your face, and again I thought that was strange. And then she went out to go to the toilet, and when she tried to come back in, she couldn't get up the step into the house. And then she tried to get into her bed and she couldn't lift her back feet into her bed. So obviously I called the vet and they said to bring her in at 3, and that was at like 9:30, 9:45. It was before 10 o'clock anyway. And then it's now 10:45, so like an hour later if that, and she doesn't seem to be able to walk anymore. She tried to follow me out into the garden because I went out to feed the rabbits, and she just flopped down onto her bum, and doesn't seem to really be able to bear weight on her back feet right now. So I called the vet back and said, look, she's deteriorated already. Can you get her in any sooner? And they said they could see her at 11:30. So I'm going to take her in at 11:30. Thankfully, we live 5 minutes away from the vets. I won't be able to go in with her. I'll just have to wait in the car park. I have a feeling that they'll say she... Well, this morning when she was still walking, I thought they would say she needs painkillers and crate rest and just to see how she goes with that. That's normally the first port of call with them when they're still walking. But now that she doesn't seem to really be able to walk, they might want to do x-rays or something. She's insured, so I'm not worried about the money, although it'll be a bit of an issue if they want me to pay up front and then settle with the insurer, because I can't pay for super expensive stuff right now. That's why my pets are insured. But they might still just go down the painkillers and crate rest route. I've like gently felt all along her back and everything. She hasn't shown any signs of being in pain, which was reassuring, but then also worries me, because if she can't feel pain and there is something there that should be causing her pain, that's not a good sign either. So I'm very upset, obviously. Cannot believe that all of this is happening right now on top of everything else. I'm just really hoping that she's going to be okay. She's just laying in her bed right now. But yeah, so I'm going to take her to the vet in about 40 minutes and hopefully they will be able to sort her out, or at least find out what's wrong.
Here she is. She's just sunning herself. Just sunning herself, aren't you, Winnie? You okay?
She's genuine. Like, this isn't unusual behaviour for her, like laying in her bed and just laying there. But, I mean, she does this all day, every day. But it's the fact that she isn't, like, bearing weight on her legs.
My poor girlie. You're not going to be happy when I leave you with the vet either.
She's sat herself up now. To sit herself up, she put her weight on her back legs for a couple of seconds and then just flopped them down. She's telling you off, Archie. She doesn't want your kisses right now. No. My princess. Yeah. Love you too. Can you see Archie in my armpit? I'm trying to stay optimistic. Because there's lots that vets can do these days, the same with human medicine. But I just can't believe this is happening right now. And it's every Dachshund owner's worst nightmare to come up against back issues. And I've seen so many of my friends and their dogs have to go through it, and it's horrible. And I just hoped that it wouldn't happen to us. This might be something different, but it's probably not. It's just crazy, like, she was absolutely fine yesterday. Like, absolutely fine. And then this morning, she's like this, and it's just crazy how quickly it's happened with like no trigger. I don't know what's caused this. So obviously I will keep you updated, but I'm just gonna carry on. I'm sitting here with her for now.
Here she is. We're just waiting for them to come and get her. Such a good girl.
Sorry for the annoying steering wheel angle. There is nowhere for my phone to go in the car right now. So I've been sat in the car park for 30 minutes and one of the vet nurses finally just came and got Winnie. They told me to call when I arrived, so I called at 11:27 and at 12 o'clock they finally came and got her. Just in case anyone's wondering like what the process is. Obviously this might not be the same at all vets, but I booked the appointment, you pull up in the car park, you call them to let them know that you're here, and then the vet calls you, asks for like a rundown on what's going on. A vet nurse comes out in PPE to collect your pet and then takes them in. They have their examination, then they come out again to give you your pet back, and then the vet calls you again to let you know what's going on, what their recommendation is, what their prescription is, and the prescription will come out with the pet, and then you have to call reception to pay over the phone for the consultation and whatever they've prescribed. So it's a bit of a faff, but obviously it's what's necessary right now. This is the first time that I've driven my car since the 6th of March, so that was a bit weird. Nice to know I haven't forgotten how to drive, at least. Poor Winnie was not happy to be picked up by a stranger, which was not very nice. There's two men over the road having an argument about whether or not they can park here. Bit stressful, to be honest. Lots of people have sent kind messages on Twitter and Instagram because I posted about it on there, because I posted about my whole life online, and yeah, I really appreciate people's kind messages, especially from people who have been through it, because back issues with a dachshund is just not fun. She took a couple of wobbly steps when we were at home because she tried to follow me to the craft room when I was getting her harness out, so she can still take a couple of steps. Whereas before it looked like she couldn't put weight on her back legs at all, but I'm just gonna wait and see what the vet says. I think that they're gonna do painkillers and crate rest, and then if that doesn't help, then I think they'll go down the x-ray route, because at the moment she just doesn't seem to be in pain or anything. It might not be her back at all, it could be something totally unrelated and she's just tired and like doesn't feel well, which is why she doesn't want to walk around. So we'll see what they think. Yeah, not how I thought my day was going to go at all.
Hello. We're home from the vets now. It's nearly 1:30. I've had some lunch. Winnie is all settled. So I thought I would come and update you. Hello, Archie. Yes. Archie's feeling very left out today. So I waited 35 minutes for the vet to come out and get her, which wasn't great because it's a hot day today. Sat in that car, but yeah, they took her in and they said that she was walking in the consultation room, especially when they got treats out, which doesn't surprise me at all because she is the most food obsessed dog that I've ever known of, ever. And they said that all of her, like the neurological tests that they do, they all seemed fine, so it didn't seem like there was any neurological reason for her legs to be sort of going out from under her. So I must admit I was a little bit put out, because the vet was absolutely lovely and he called me and said, you know, she's walking around for a treat, and was sort of saying that she's just an old dog, and I was trying to explain that this has happened overnight. Like last night she was absolutely fine, she was running about like normal. Every single day she sprints out of her bed to be let out in the morning. Like, she's so excited to be let out of the crate in the morning and she goes running to the door. And she didn't do that today. She couldn't really walk. And then the reason I got the vet appointment brought forward was because she really couldn't walk. Her legs were going out from underneath her. She was just flopping down. And she seemed really uncomfortable. So he was like, you know, for now, I'll just prescribe painkillers and like bed rest, essentially, which is what I thought they would do for the next couple of days. And he wants me to call them back and update them tomorrow to see how she's doing. But he thinks she might have just pulled something, because I did really sort of stress to him, like, this is not her normal behaviour. She doesn't normally act like an old dog, like, so much so that we've wondered whether she is actually the age that she is supposed to be, because she's not like an old dog. So I did sort of stress that to him, and he said, you know, it could be the beginning of spinal issues, it could be the beginning of arthritis or something like that. So we've given her pain relief, she had an injection of pain relief, and then they've sent me home with the like oral Metacam to give her for the next couple of days. And as soon as we got home, she was already more comfortable. She took a couple of steps and tried to take herself outside. Obviously, I'm not going to let her do any jumping or anything, so I carried her outside and carried her back in. And she's just asleep in her bed now, but she was sort of like pottering around a little bit. So that says to me that she was definitely in pain, and obviously now she's had pain relief, she's feeling better. So we'll keep that up for a couple of days and keep her rested, like in her bed as much as possible, and just see how she goes. That is nice. But yeah, bless her, she's fast asleep right now. And I feel a bit more calm now that I know that she is comfortable. Obviously, I'm worried that as soon as the painkillers stop, it's all gonna, you know, kick back off. So hopefully she has just pulled something and it will be, what are you doing? And it will be fine in a couple of days. Ow, Georgie. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. I'll keep you updated, obviously. But yeah, this is just not how I thought my Wednesday was gonna go. It's a beautiful, warm, sunny day out there, and I just want to go back to bed and start this day again. We've come out for a little cup of tea and a toilet break. As you can see, she's on her feet and her tail's wagging, but she's just very reluctant to walk. And obviously I'm not gonna make her walk because she's on bed rest now. But she got up and went to the back door, so I thought she needed the toilet, but she doesn't seem to want to do anything now. Oh. You okay? She's just plonked herself down, so maybe she just wanted to sit in the sun for a minute. Look at these. They just arrived in the post. They're from, guys. They're from a shop called Cheeky Beans UK. I'll leave the link in the description. I bought these myself. This isn't an ad or gifted or anything. I bought them myself. I bought them at the beginning of lockdown, so they have taken quite a long time to arrive, but they are perfect. Oh my gosh, I love them. My angel boy, keeping me company out here. Winnie's asleep, and I'm just watching all of Lucy Wood's lockdown videos that she's done. I think she is an actual ray of sunshine. She is so cute. I love her videos. We can smell barbecue, can't we, Archie? It smells delicious out here.
So it's now like 7 o'clock. Yep, 7:05. I've been going between the sofa and the garden all day. I've been out sunbathing because, as you can see, my legs literally reflect the sun. But somebody is feeling much, much better this evening, thank goodness. I do think it's just the effects of the painkillers, so obviously I'm not going to let her keep walking around. But I did their dinner and she was much, much more excited than she was this morning. As you can see, she's now licking Archie's bowl clean. That's hers over there. But yeah, she is much brighter than she was this morning. So at least I know she's not in pain now. I do think it was some sort of pain that was stopping her from walking earlier, which makes me really sad, and we need to figure out what it is. But yeah, I'm going to keep her on bed rest, obviously. But I just thought you would want to know that she's much happier. Winnie, what are we really licking the floor? Wins. So sorry that it's gotten dark in here all of a sudden. But I can't remember if I showed you, these were the chairs that Will picked up at B&Q yesterday, and they sold him the wrong table. We managed to get the correct table, which is now in stock at our local store, for click and collect. So I think we're going to pick that up over the next couple of days, and I'll be able to put a cute little table and chairs set outside. It even matches the shed. Excuse all the rubbish, it needs to go to the tip. Yeah, so we'll be able to have a table and chairs finally for the first time ever. We had one in our old house. Will's sister gave it to us, and Will accidentally smashed the glass table by putting a portable barbecue on top of it. So yeah, but yeah, we've got two of these little chairs, and then we'll have the matching table. Here she comes. Look, she's much better. No, Winnie, don't jump out. But yeah, she's much, much happier. I really need to de-weed this patio properly. Will was like, I de-weeded the patio, as you can see. He didn't de-weed the patio.
Morning everyone, happy Thursday. I'm wearing the same outfit again today and I look like this because my mum had to drop one of their dogs at the vet this morning, super early, and the vet is like 5 minutes from my house. So she said that she would drop a hammock on the doorstep for us. It's in a box, obviously. She shouldn't just leave the whole hammock outside the house. But they have two and they literally never use the second one. They've never even built it. So she asked if we would like it and I said, yes, please. So I've just been stood for like half an hour having a nice socially distanced chat with her. And I just feel so much better after I've been able to like see and speak to my mum and like see that she's okay and everything. It's so nice. And speaking of being okay, little Miss Winnie, who's over in her bed at the moment, is pretty much back to her normal self this morning. She does have a snuggle sack in her crate at night, and in hindsight, there probably isn't enough room in the crate for her to like wiggle into it and out of it effectively. So I'm wondering if maybe she sort of got stuck trying to turn round in that and twinged her back or something overnight, and that's why she was in pain yesterday. But she is pretty much her normal self today, which is such a relief. But obviously I'm going to follow the vet's advice and keep her as quiet as possible, although she's currently taking herself outside right now. I'm going to try and keep her as quiet as possible and give her the painkillers if she seems to need it. But I'm tempted to hold off today because she is honestly like 100% her normal self and I don't want to give her drugs that she doesn't need. But yeah, such a relief. Very expensive way of finding out that my dog had probably just twinged herself slightly, but it's worth it, I don't care. So yeah, I'm gonna go and build my hammock. I'm really excited, and there's so many flies in here because the door's open. That is the worst part about summer, all the bugs.
I didn't film putting together the hammock, although it was pretty easy, but the actual hammock itself is stretched so tautly between these two that it looks lovely when there's someone laying in it, but when there isn't it's literally like a straight line, and I couldn't get into the hammock at all which is why Will's in it. Picked up our table from B&Q, so we've now got our little table and chairs as well. So cute. And our hammock. The garden looks full of stuff all of a sudden, but it's fine. Look how cute. It's not like my first choice, but the chairs are comfy and everything else is out of stock, so for now this will do. Guys, I'm doing the washing at the moment. I'm covered in Vector 50 because I've been out in the garden most of the day. I had a really nice phone call with my nan earlier. It's her birthday today. She's 75, I think, today. And I had sent her a card and everything in the post, but obviously I wanted to speak to her on her birthday. So I called her and we were on the phone for like 40 minutes, and that was so nice. And then I've just been out in the garden reading and just enjoying the sun. I started to feel like I was going a bit red, so I've slathered on loads more sun cream so that I can go back out there in a bit. But I'm so happy with how the garden's looking. It's so nice to have that little table and chairs now so we can go out and sit out there. It's not like my first choice for what I would have chosen, but it's basically all there is that's in stock at the moment. And I'm really happy with it. I love the hammock as well. I've been laying in the hammock and Will's just been out there while I've been inside. It's so nice. It's so nice. I can't wait till we can actually have people round because the garden looks so much better now than it did. But like I said, I'm doing the washing. I'm putting clean washing away and then I'm going to put a load of washing on. And I've cleaned the kitchen and there's a bunch of other stuff that needs doing as well, but we'll just see what I feel like doing.
Morning, everyone. Happy Saturday. I didn't really film anything yesterday because I really was not feeling very well. As soon as I woke up yesterday morning, I just knew that it was potentially not going to be a very good day. I'm having real trouble with my Crohn's, and there's some other stuff going on as well that I don't really want to discuss at the moment, health-wise. And I just can't believe that I'm feeling ill again so soon after being in hospital. The last 2 years have just been really not good for my health, or a lot of life things in general, to be honest. But I just did not feel up to filming yesterday, so I basically just laid on the couch pretty much all day and watched films. I've watched 5 of the like original 6 Star Wars films now, and I'm actually really enjoying them. So who knew? I'm a Star Wars fan after all. I want to watch episode 3 today at some point, but I've woken up feeling a little bit better than I did yesterday, so I'm trying to get some stuff done while I feel okay. So I got up, I made us breakfast, we had bacon sandwiches, and then I've changed the bedding, and now I'm going through my wardrobe because I still haven't vacuum packed and put away all of my winter and like Christmas stuff, because obviously I was so poorly at the beginning of the year, I just didn't do it. Plus I was still using a lot of my jumpers and stuff, so I need to vacuum pack all of that away and get out all my summer things, because it looks like, fingers crossed, the warm weather is here to stay with us for a little while. So I'm going to do that and I'll show you what I'm up to while I'm doing it.
Right, well over an hour later, I'm finally at some sort of like finish point for now. These are all the summer clothes that I want to keep but need to be ironed, and I really can't be bothered to do it now, so I'm going to leave it till later. I've run out of hangers anyway, so even if I iron it, they'll then get really crumpled again because I'll just have to fold them, so it's better than nothing though. I've got a little pile here for the charity shop or like clothes bank. And then one of my vacuum bags broke, so I've had to put it inside that suitcase, and that can go up in the loft. And yeah, everything else is in the wardrobe.
Hello everyone, happy Sunday. We've made it through another week. I look about as rough as I feel today. My skin is really playing up and I just generally don't feel very well and haven't felt very well for most of this week, to be honest, but I've been trying to be optimistic and positive, but it's just not really working. So I'm going to end this vlog here because I'm not feeling very well right now and it's highly unlikely that I'm going to be able to film anything else. But I wanted to properly end the vlog because I realised that I hadn't really updated you on my reading all week after saying I was taking part in that readathon this week. Basically, I read one book and I haven't finished any more since then. But anyway, yeah, I'm still reading that book that I mentioned, it might have been Tuesday, called My Little Eye, I Spy With My Little Eye or something like that. And I'm enjoying it, but I just haven't read very much of it because my eyes have really been playing up. So I've mainly been like crafting and watching stuff on my tablet this week. I finished the like original six Star Wars films. So I've watched the original trilogy, and then the prequel trilogy. And I've really enjoyed them. I'm a closet Star Wars fan, who knew? I don't think I have anything else to update you on. I've literally just been like watching films and lots of Disney vlogs to try and cheer me up. I do actually feel like okay in myself. I just feel really poorly. So yeah, hopefully I will be feeling better very soon. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. If you have any questions or comments, let me know. And I will see you next time. Bye guys.